الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه ولبيته من اتبع سنته أجمعين. فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Today alhamdulillah we will be discussing and learning about Surah Al-Qasas. And Surah Al-Qasas is the 49th surah revealed to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. In this surah, ayat number 52 to 55 and 75 are revealed in Medina, and rest of the surah is revealed in Makkah. And today it is at the 27th surah, a 28th position surah in the Quran, in the sequence of recitation. Surah Al-Qasas again is a Makki surah, as I said, and it was the time when Prophet is trying to communicate and invite the Meccans to the Islam, and the things are getting harsher and much more aggressive behavior from the Quraysh. They are not at all soft or kind towards Muslim, and their behavior is becoming to the point where Muslims are having very hard time to be living there. With this thing in mind, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding repeatedly about the what happened with the people of Pharaoh and the people of Prophet Musa, and what happened, these stories about different people in the time, were like Qarun was one of the cousins of Prophet, and we will talk about him as the time comes, as the surah talks about it, and ultimately it ending about the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and his day of judgment, and all what will be happening to the people and the day of judgment, a person who lives in faith and dies in and or out of faith. And as always, there is a communication or expression towards the Christians and Jews. Surah Al-Qasas, it is again, it was revealed after Surah Naml, which we did last time. And according to Ibn Abbas and Jabir bin Zayd, Surah Ash-Shu'ara, An-Naml and Al-Qasas were revealed one after the other during the middle time, which is the seventh year of prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. So let's begin.
In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, Tasin Mim. These are verses of the clear book.
نَتْلُو عَلَيْكَ مِنْ نَبَإِ مُوسَى وَفِرْعَوْنَ بِالْحَقِّ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ.
We recite to you a part of the story of Musa and Pharaoh with truth for people who believe.
إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِنْهُمْ يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم إنه كان من المفسدين.
Indeed, Pharaoh had become high-handed in the land and had divided its people into different groups. He used to persecute a group of them, slaughtering their sons and keeping their women alive. Indeed, he was one of the mischief makers.
ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين.
While we intended to favor those who were held as weak in the land and to make them leaders and make them inheritors.
ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما منهم ما كانوا يحذرون.
And give them power in the land, and to show Pharaoh, Haman and their armies the very thing they were fearing from them.
Well,
so the first six verses, as we see, the first verse is three letters, Ta, Si, Mim, Huruf Muqatiat, begin with the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. These three letters, Allah knows the meaning, Prophets knows the understanding, and we just accept them as they are. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to the Quran because Quraysh thought that the Quran was fabricated, na'uzu billah, by Prophet. So these are the verses of the clear book, means the Quran. Natlu alayka min naba'i Musa wa Fir'auna bilhaqq liqawmi yu'minun. And we recite to you the part of the story. You see, this is now how many times you have heard this story, but each time there's a new, it's about something new about it, the new angle, a new elaboration of the event, what happened between Prophet Musa and Fir'aun. Now the Musa alayhi salam is the powerful messenger of Allah. Fir'aun is the powerful king, a superpower of its time. And this is how we see when German, what the Hitler did to the people of Israel, which was the what we call the Jews today, that he chose and picked people and he killed them. And this has happened in our recent history, and this happened about 4,000 plus years ago. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that time when the Prophet Muhammad was about 1400, 1500 years ago. Today we have the new year started last week, which is 1443 of Islamic Hijra calendar, which marks the emigration of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, from Mecca to Medina. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to this reference. Indeed, Fir'aun had high-handed or high-hearted situation in the land, and he divide people into groups. As you know, divide and rule is the policy of every powerful government or the rulers, and this is what he did. And what he would do is that he will kill their son and leave their daughters so that they could be still producing children, yet they will not be dangerous to the king. And this is because some of the sorcerers who were in his the people who would do the stargazing and calculation, they said that there will be a child will be born among the Israelites who will be endangering your kingdom and will be your enemy. So he would do is he started killing all of the at one time. Then they realized there was not much male born, so what they did is he would leave one ear and kill the other ear born children. So his Musa alayhi salam's elder brother Harun alayhi salam, he was born in the year when he would not kill the boys, and the Musa alayhi salam himself was born with the year when he would kill the boys. And his mother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the story of that which we heard earlier, he inspired her and she hid him, and he grew very rapidly as a physical body, even though he was a little newborn, and he would look like a grown-up baby, and about within 3-4 months he would look like almost like a year old baby. And what happened is this time his mother could not keep him anymore safe, and Musa alayhi salam, according to some of the narration, that his mother would cover his face with a cloth when somebody would come, and he would be quiet, he would not make a noise, and when they will leave, then she will talk to him or nurse him or keep him. So then Pharaoh was fooled by this, and same year the further story will come that his mother was inspired by Allah to put him in a box and prepare it with the inner as waterproof, and let it go into the river Nile. And his mother, his sister was told to follow him and see what happened. And Fir'aun with his wife Asiya radiallahu anha, she did not believe in Fir'aun, and she had become actually a believer, and she is the one who took Musa alayhi salam as a baby. And this is all situation evolved, and when Musa alayhi salam was being taken, she said, take this baby, it will be beneficial for us. He said, well, where this baby comes from, so and so forth. At that time he did not have children, and she did not have child. So she said that I will have a baby, and according to the queen's desire, he was captain. And Musa alayhi salam was raised, and when they wanted to nurse him, he would not drink milk from anybody. Finally, his sister went and said, I know the family he can drink milk from. So they went and brought his mother. When she came in, Musa alayhi salam's blessed mother, when she came in and she tried to nurse the Musa alayhi salam, as soon as he saw her, he stopped crying. So Fir'aun was suspicious. He said, how come this thing happening? It must be a Jewish family planning something which was not Jewish, which was Muslim of Arab. They were brother of Muslim, and they were the Muslim of the time. So she answered very intelligently. She said, it's not because of anything. It is because some children like to be with the clean people, and I take a bath every day, and this is why the baby is comfortable with me. So he kind of understood. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made such provision that Fir'aun said, this baby, you keep him, nurse him, and bring him to us. And he set up a stipend for her. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a source of subsistence and living. And then the Musa alayhi salam, when he grew up further, he came to the palace and lived with the Pharaoh. And this is how this what happened. And this is how when he grew up, there's a story coming about what happened when one of the people of Pharaoh or the Egyptian, when he was trying to unjustly hurt a Israelite, which was a Muslim, and Musa alayhi salam tried to stop him, and this man would not listen, and Musa alayhi salam struck him with his hand trying to stop, and he died from this blow of the power of his hand, which was unintentional. And when the murder happened, this person who he was fighting for next day was found to be fighting for another person. And next day when Musa alayhi salam tried to stop him, this person who was basically a Muslim and he did not know Prophet Musa was the Prophet of Allah, he just knew that he is a he's an Israelite who is raised in the palace and he was a prince for them. So he said, you are gonna kill me like the other day you kill another person. And then everybody got to know that this is the man who killed the other day Egyptian who they were looking for, who is the murderer. Musa alayhi salam, when he learned about it, a man who liked Musa alayhi salam, he came and he said, they are planning and looking for you, so run away from here. And he ran to Madayan, and the further story we will talk as it comes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the inspiration which he gave to the mother of Musa alayhi salam. And please go ahead and we will listen to the next verse.
وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي إِنَّا رَادُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ
We inspired the mother of Musa saying, suckle him, Musa. Then once you fear about him, cast him in the river, and do not fear, and do not grieve. Surely we are going to bring him back to you and appoint him one of our messengers. So the family of Pharaoh picked him up, so that he becomes for them an enemy and a cause of grief. Indeed Pharaoh, Haman and their armies were mistaken.
وقالت امرأة فرعون قرة عين لي ولك لا تقتلوه عسى أن ينفعنا أو نتخذه ولدا عسى أن ينفعنا أو نتخذه ولدا وهم لا يشعرون.
And the wife of Pharaoh said to Pharaoh about Musa, he may be a delight of eye for me and you. Do not kill him. It is hoped that he will be of benefit to us, or we will adopt him as his son. And they were not aware of what was going to happen.
وأصبح فؤاد أم موسى فارغا إن كادت لتبدي به لولا أن ربطنا على قلبها لتكون من المؤمنين.
And the heart of the mother of Musa became restless. Indeed, she was about to disclose this, the real facts about Musa, had we not strengthened her heart to remain among those with a firm belief in Allah's promise.
وقالت لأخته قصيه فبصرت به عن جنب وهم لا يشعرون.
She said to his sister, keep track of him. So she watched him from a distance, while they were not aware.
وحرمنا عليه المراضع من قبل فقالت هل أدلكم على أهل بيت يكفلونه لكم وهم له ناصحون.
And we had already barred him, Musa, from accepting any suckling women. So she, his sister, said to Pharaoh's people, shall I point out to you a family who will nurse him for you, and they will be his well-wishers?
فرددناه إلى أمه كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن ولتعلم أن وعد الله حق ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون.
Thus we brought him back to his mother, so that her eye might have comfort and she might not grieve, and so that she might know that Allah's promise is true, but most of them do not know.
ولما بلغ أشده واستوى آتيناه حكما وعلما وكذلك نجزي المحسنين.
And when he reached his maturity and became perfect, we gave him wisdom and knowledge. This is how we reward those who are good in their deeds.
ودخل المدينة على حين غفلة من أهلها فوجد فيها رجلين يقتتلان هذا من شيعته وهذا من عدوه فاستغاثه الذي من شيعته على الذي من عدوه فوكزه موسى فقضى عليه قال هذا من عمل الشيطان إنه عدو مضل مبين.
Once he entered the city at a time when its people were heedless. So he found in it two men fighting each other, this one was from his own group, and that one from his enemies. So the one from his own group called him for help against the one who was from his enemies. So Musa gave him a blow with his fist and finished him off. Then he, Musa, said, out of remorse, this is some of Satan's act. He is indeed a clear enemy who misleads people.
قال رب إني ظلمت نفسي فاغفر لي فغفر له إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
He said, O my Lord, I have wronged myself, so forgive me. So he forgave him. Indeed he is the most forgiving, very merciful.
قال رب بما أنعمت علي فلن أكون ظهيرا للمجرمين.
He, Musa, said, O my Lord, as you have favored me, I will never be a supporter of the sinners.
فأصبح في المدينة خائفا يترقب فإذا الذي استنصره بالأمس يستصرخه. قال له موسى إنك لغوي مبين.
Then next morning he was fearful in the city, waiting for what comes next, when the man who sought his help the day before shouted to him for help again. Musa said to him, You are surely a clear troublemaker.
فلما أن أراد أن يبطش بالذي هو عدو لهما قال يا موسى قال يا موسى أتريد أن تقتلني كما قتلت نفسا بالأمس إن تريد إلا أن تكون جبارا في الأرض وما تريد أن تكون من المصلحين.
Thereafter when he intended to grasp at the one who was an enemy to both of them, he, for example, the Israelite, said, O Musa, Do you want to kill me as you have killed a person yesterday? Your intention is only to become a tyrant in the land, and you do not intend to be one of the peacemakers.
وجاء رجل من أقصى المدينة يسعى قال يا موسى إن الملأ يأتمرون بك ليقتلوك فاخرج إني لك من الناصحين.
And there came a man running from the farthest part of the city. He said, The chiefs are counseling each other about you, so that they kill you. So, leave the city. I am one of your well-wishers.
فخرج منها خائفا يترقب قال رب نجني من القوم الظالمين.
So, he went out of it, the city, looking around in a state of fear. He said, O my Lord, save me from the cruel people.
So we could see that certain experience here. This is about the age when Musa alayhi salam is about his 30th birthday or 30th year of his life, and he was he's a strong, healthy, and a powerful man who was living a royal life, and he was living among the pharaohs because the wife of Pharaoh loved Musa alayhi salam, adopting him as a son. And he was given all the royalty protocol, and still this is understood that he was not among the people of Pharaoh, because Quran talks as if that they knew that he was an adopted son, and but some knew about it, public may not know publicly about it, but inside royalty it is something, you know. And as we also know that the king up till recent history when king believe in something, whole nation had to believe in that. And we know that in the Second World War, the Japanese king was worshipped as a god. And here is the very human experiences described about Prophet Musa alayhi salam in his 30th or approximately 30th year of his life, that he tried to help out a oppressed person as a prophet, as a man who cared. And this man was really troublemaker, as Ali radiallahu ta'ala says, when you do a favor to somebody, fear the wrath of this person. So be always watchful when you do good. And this is what happened. The same person was found next day fighting with another person. And can you please turn your mute on so that it will not interrupt? So this is how the experience of this person is. And this is where the problem happens when you when he starts saying publicly that, oh Musa, you look like you're going to kill me now. He was afraid that Musa Islam might hit him for being found, you know, unjustly arguing with people. And there are people who often, you know, you try to do help favor them and then they embarrass you publicly. It happened in this family, it happened in the community, it happened in all over the world life. So when you do good, try to be careful. That's all what it is. And then when he was afraid, he ran onto the Madayan. When he went, arrived there, he found the people near the water, and water well was the use. And after, next to the water well, they used to make a little pond where they will pull water from the well, put it for the animal or grazing animal like flocks to drink water from there. And he found that the his wife, Safura radiallahu ta'ala anha, who later he married to, and her sister were there, were the daughters of Shu'aib alayhi salam. And these women were standing for quite a while in the distance. Even though Musa alayhi salam was hungry and he was weak and he was tired and he was afraid of his life as he has run out from the from Egypt. So he went to the east. East is the Madayan, northeast of it, which is the north of Saudi Arabia, northwest of Saudi Arabia today. So when he arrived there, he found that these women are not getting water. And that time he told them, why you're not getting water? That these women said, we are not getting it because we have to wait till these men have done, and we do not want to go there. This is the modesty and shyness among them. And then he helped them. He helped them to get the water for their flocks. And then when they did it, these women went home, and they told their dad when he Shu'aib alayhi salam, then they had come earlier than they are, you know, usually late, because these were waiting for the other man to finish. It was a daily routine. So these women tell, or the girls tell the dad about, we found this man who was strong, who was nice and respectful, and he helped us. So Shu'aib alayhi salam, being the prophet, he asked them to bring Musa alayhi salam to them. And when they were about to bring him, they came to ask him to come, and he was modest. He said he did not look at them. He kept his gaze down. This is the men's command, that keep your gaze down. And they came in, and the etiquettes of the wife of Musa alayhi salam is described, who was a future wife, that how she walked, how she dressed, how she spoke, with the modesty, with the shyness, with proper covering. And he made them walk behind, even though they were going to lead him. He said, no, I do not want to look at you, because the wind might blow your cover and that might expose your body to me. So he said, walk behind me and tell me which way to go. This was a prophetic way of doing things. So let's listen to that.